A new report from the Daily Beast came out this week showing that the Joint Political Action Committee called Put America First from Matt Gaetz and Marjorie Taylor Greene has effectively gone bust. They're broke. They're not pulling in any money. And in fact, to make it even worse, over the last 3 months of last year, October, November, December, there was only one donation made to Put America First. And it actually came from Matt Gaetz' own campaign, and it was $18,000, and it's believed that this was to cover any outstanding debts that the group still had. So basically, Put America First, Matt Gaetz and Marjorie Taylor Greene's little pack baby, has nothing. It was a complete and total failure from the start. And here's what happened. Matt Gaetz and Marjorie Taylor Greene, of course, last summer announced they're going on tour. We're going across the country. And we've started this political action committee to raise money and, of course, help to fund their trip across the country. And what happened every time was, sure, people would show up and they'd give money, but it was never enough to even cover the cost of whatever rally they were doing. So let's say they go out and they do a rally in California. They pay $100,000 to rent a venue, to put everything on, security, all of that, but they only raise $80,000. So it's a net loss of $20,000. Now, that's just an obscure example. I'm making those particular numbers up to give you a good feel of what was happening all over the country. And that is what happened. They'd go out, they'd raise money, but they'd have to spend even more to raise it. So this car was running out of gas before they even pulled out of the gas station because nobody wanted to give these two wackos any money. Now, of course, Marjorie Taylor Greene did raise quite a bit of money for her actual campaign. And every now and then, both her and Gaetz, you know, as I mentioned, would have to funnel money back over to the Political Action Committee because they couldn't cover the costs they were incurring. But Marjorie Taylor Greene was still making money with her actual campaign. Gaetz, on the other hand, according to these reports, really can't say the same about that. Gaetz was smashing, not records, but close to smashing records in the first 6 months of last year. But it was once that scandal dropped in the second quarter of last year, or towards the end of the first quarter, I guess, things did slow down a bit. He still, again, raised plenty of money in the second quarter, but then once it started to heat up over the summer, the money started drying up. He dropped $1 million last year alone fighting the fallout from that scandal. $1 million. He now has $1.5 million cash on hand, which for somebody with such a high profile, somebody who toured the country last summer, having only $1.5 million on hand is not a good look. It's not a lot of money. Granted, Matt Gaetz typically doesn't do any kind of actual campaigning down here in his district. He doesn't have to run ads. He doesn't have to really do anything at all. So maybe it doesn't hurt him. Maybe it does. He's got some stiff competition in both the Republican primary and on the Democratic side this time. So he may need that money to fight. And unfortunately for him, he's about to go into this campaign cycle with the least amount of money that he has had to date. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.